Hello. And yes, I am in my pajamas. Okay, so this is a mudra that I've been talking about all week, and it's the Lotus Mudra, and I love this. Sorry, I'm a heart after just teaching. So for this mudra, the Lotus represents enlightenment. It represents a renewal, a rebirth. And quite often it's about us trying to find answers. And when really bad things happen, the first thing you want to do is ask why. Why do things happen, especially to good people? And sometimes it's really hard to answer those. And we live in a mad world at the moment. Personally, I think everything's rushing. We're told all the time that we're meant to have things, we can buy things that we haven't got the money to buy, and it's insane that we've become so attached to so many things in this world and this existence. And the thing is that it's not real, is it? All of these things that we possess, are you going to take them with you when you go? No, you're not. There is more to you, like the Who Am I meditation I was doing. You're not just body, and not just the emotions, and you are not just your mind. There is more to you. Everything that you do and everything that you say and everything you've experienced, the things that you give out, like karma, will come back to you. And this mudra, the Lotus, when we do this mudra, for me, the mudra, when I do this, I use it as a meditation. And what I'm imagining, I'm like the lotus flower that I'm trying to rise up through the mud, and I'm searching, I'm looking for that light like the lotus flower does. But I'm reminding myself, when the hands come back down, I'm reminding myself I'm still earth, I'm still grounded, I'm still connected to this planet and connected to every other living creature, person that is on this planet. And this lotus flower, it is reminding us that we have a deep connection to everybody else, that we're not ignorant to our own real self, our true self, the witness, the I, not the person who needs to go and buy a Costa every day, which I don't, I'm learning how not to do that, but all of those things, they are not things that you need, they're things that you want. And you sometimes can meet these amazing people who've come through hell on earth, and there's still a serenity about them. And that's because they've learned to rise above it, like the lotus flower rises up through the mud. And avidya, all of the darkness, all of the things that don't matter, all of that, the ignorance, is dropped, it falls away. And when I do this meditation, this lotus flower, this is how I feel. I feel as if it's me trying to rise up above. So, you're going to bring your hands, after I spoke for the last 3 minutes, you're going to bring your hands into a lotus flower. Now, you're not going to be able to see my hands, so I'm going to have to move back possibly. So I'm going to go a little bit further back towards the wall so you can see. Yes, I am in pajamas. What I'm doing. So make your lotus flower mudra. Thumbs are touching, little fingers are touching. And what you're going to do is you breathe in, you're going to raise your lotus flower up. Now, my hands are continuing to rise, and the palms of the hands are going to touch, and then I'm going to let my fingertips start to touch, and then I'm going to start to bring the backs of my hands together, and the fingers are going to come back down towards the earth. So even though you won't be able to see my hands in a moment, don't worry about that. So breathe in as you raise your lotus flower up. The palms touch as you reach the top of the inhalation. And as you exhale, bring the fingertips together and let the backs of the hands start to touch. So you are reminding yourself that you are still rooted and grounded to the earth with the exhalation. So breathing in, the hands raise. You rise the lotus flower up. And above a video. When you exhale, you ground and you root yourself back. Connect yourself back to everything and everyone else that's important. you raise the lotus flower, and exhaling as you root to the earth. The lotus lifts, exhaling the lotus. You do not have to do anything else and make your lotus and ground and root yourself to the earth. Do this for as long as you wish. The image of the lotus as it lifts, rising above all that holds you down, holds you back. And when you have finished your meditation, just bring the backs of your hands onto your knees. You can do that sitting in a chair. Just allow the palms to be open. Just allow yourself to be still again for a few moments. Bring your hands into your prayer position, Anjali at the heart, and Namaste. So obviously, you only need to learn how to do that once.